The main problem that introverts and most people experience is not knowing how to start a conversation when you meet someone. Let me tell you how you can start a conversation with someone, whatever may be the place or situation. Welcome to another episode of Global Banking Finance Review. My name is Deepika Lobo. Today we're going to talk about how to start a conversation. Start with the weather. One of the oldest and most popular ways to start a conversation is to talk about the weather. It's a fine day, isn't it? Or it's so dull and gloomy. Hope the weather clears up soon. A good example is to start a conversation using weather. Based on the response of the other person, you can continue the conversation by moving on to other topics. From weather, you can talk about why you are at that place and let the conversation flow. It's advisable to leave out religion and politics when you are starting a conversation. After all, you want to start a conversation and not a fight. Start talking about the situation or venue. When you meet someone, it will be at a venue or in a particular situation. To start with that, for example, if you are at a party, you can probably start with, X has organized a great party today. I'm glad I'm here. If you are at an office event, you can start the conversation by talking about the event. You could start with, this is the first time I'm making a presentation. How about you? This not only starts the conversation, but also draws the other person into it. Start with an introduction. This is the best way, especially at business events where people meet to network. You can walk to the person you want to talk to, offer your hand and say, hi, I'm X. You can move the conversation forward by telling something about your work, career, in one line and explain why you are at this event. This approach would be good at work or business events, but may not be so suitable for social events. Compliment the other person. One good way of doing this is by offering a compliment. You should do this only if you are sincere about it or there is something worth complimenting. If you are at an official event, you can offer a compliment to other person on the talk he delivered or on the award he received. This will help to start a conversation. A compliment will flatter most people and make them open up to you. Don't offer a compliment that sounds fake or artificial. Talk about a mutual friend. If you have a mutual friend, maybe the host of the party, you can start the conversation by talking about him. How do you know X? Or, I know X from a long time, he's such a great guy. These can be a good way to start a conversation. If you meet a new colleague at office, you can talk about the boss. That would be a good enough subject to start a conversation. Starting a conversation with someone from the opposite sex. This is one of the reasons most people like to start a conversation. You have to start talking without sounding flirty. One of the best ways to do it is to ask the direction to some place. For example, can you tell me where the library is? You can even ask the other person something specific, like are you here for the training on Java? You can then use the IFR technique to take the conversation ahead. You can check out our video on IFR technique for more details. Follow-up is important. Starting a conversation can be done in any of the ways listed above. Once you start a conversation, follow up by continuing the talk. Talk more about the other person, not only yourself. This is the best way to make the other person respond to you. This is a great way to move the conversation ahead and get to know the other person. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And one lucky winner will win a 1-year free subscription of Global Banking and Finance TV magazine.